Puppet Rebellion with Slave, you know, now that is definitely different from a lot of their older stuff, and that is really cool. Like, I love the direction they've gone in. I mean, a little bit more, just a little bit heavier, but just like I love the mix of the vocals and the different effects on it. Like, really dug that. Like, very cool.
Yeah, I mean they've definitely I mean the lead singer Ollie, he has held it all together, and you've still got some of the original members, which is fantastic. But I think it still has that Puppet Rebellion edge, you know, strength and edge to it, which is great. Very catchy,
For sure.
cool rhythm, and I think, you know, they just need a break, don't they? That's the thing with these bands. It makes me want to go and see them again, which is it's always a good thing. So I may have to do a little bit of, you know, travelling up north and going to catch a few bands, because there's been quite a few that I, you know, would like to see. Because I always think live, you get a much better kind of feeling for the band, don't you?
Oh, for
So,
sure.
you know, so yeah, cool. I'm just, it's so glad. I mean, I'm so glad we can share it. It's like really exciting.
You're excited for these nipples.
I'm not even
Weren't expecting that, were you? Wasn't expecting that. No, not at all.
It's not even midnight yet.
I wasn't expecting that. No. So, next up is a band called Tio Rico. This one's called Somewhere Between. Dig this. Go with Somewhere in Between. Now that was just good old punk rock right there. That was awesome, really catchy. Love the vocals, like in maybe like early 90s kind of punk pop rock, but really cool, like really into the tune. And I always enjoy these guys' tunes.
Yeah, it's really kind of straight in and straight out, wasn't it? That was pretty quick, and
Crazy.
I kind of like that though. I think that's cool, and I really liked the gravelly vocals. So yeah, I've not heard their stuff before, I have to be honest. That's another Manchester band, isn't it?
Yep.
So there you go. My trip up north is going to be blessed with trying to catch all these guys. So very, very cool.
And some more phrasing by B, straight in, straight out.
Should I put that in my little blurb? That was
ha, yeah. Hashtag phrasing real, you know. Hey, we're all guilty of it, but it's funny. It's all good fun, so there's
Of course
no.
it is, yeah. It's all good.
Oh, please.
See, I can't misbehave. ultra good on my FM show, because we get, you know, we have to be careful. We're not allowed to swear or anything, so I have to be very good.
Oh, so this show's not important then, is it?
No. It means I can be a little bit risque on this, which is what I like.
I'm just teasing you anyway. So
it's even more important, isn't it?
I'm just teasing you. It's fine.
I can be mean.
Oh, please. No, you can't.
Okay.
So, next up is another one of your submissions.
Who is it? Wait.
The Clarions.
Which one is it? Who?
The Clarions. And it's...
Clarions.
Yeah, like we do.
Yeah, they were introduced to me by Mark Kelly, the manager. And I played them recently on my Freem FM show From the Hive. And I thought you would really like these guys, actually. And I think they've already started to make waves in Ohio. So I thought you would like it. That's why I shared it with you.
Right on. So here we go with the Clarions and Like We Do. Dig this. Right on, the Clarions with Like We Do. A very, very cool song, very catchy. Kind of remind me a little bit of Rook Assault, actually.
Yeah, they're from the same place as Dave, so Newcastle upon Tyne. They've got a double single out, and this, so 25th of September, they've got the B-side coming out to this. And it was Blast FM. Have you heard of Blast FM?
I have not.
No, well, they've picked them up somewhere, but they've been on BBC Introducing, and they've done quite a lot of gigging. They've had their debut EP out, and they were new to me, and I thought, yeah, I quite like that. It's catchy, you know. I'd like to hear a lot more from them. It's difficult, isn't it, just judging people on just one track? But I knew you'd like it. I thought it'd be up your street anyway.
It very much is. And just predict our next tune. I was thinking about this. So, B, you do realize that now when you do the show that this will end up on 6 different digital radio stations on the internet as well as iTunes and TuneIn.
Wow, no, I didn't know that.
So, yeah, you'll be on every time you co-host to be part of the show, it'll be for NMS 60. So you'll be on 6 different radio stations plus TuneIn and iTunes.
That's amazing.
Yep.
Fantastic. So Brilliant.
Well, no. All the thanks goes to Mike. Mike's done all the work for that, so it's all all thanks goes to him. He did a fantastic job. And
high five.
Exactly, right?
That's brilliant.
He's on vacation right now, but he's done a lot of work, and he's made it really good just because, like, he's got a lot more editing experience and that sort of thing to deal with than I do, so it's great that he does it, so... He's done a great job. No, I've listened to pretty much all of them, and they're really cool. I love the edits he does and the cuts he does, because there's a couple of, he's like, well, I had to edit a lot of swearing because there's one we just love the song, and it was was it Rival Tone Band, or it was either way, it was a really good heavy tune, right? We kept commenting about it, and the F bomb kept dropping, you know, that sort of thing. He's like, okay, well, I can clean that up a little bit, right? So
yeah, fair enough.
But I was like, no, it happens once in a while. We get carried away, and it's not because we want to offend anybody, just because we're excited by the music, right? It's got nothing to do with being offensive at all. So, anyways, next up, we have a band called The Crash Mats, and this one's called Let's Get Stoned. Sounds like a Bob Dylan song, eh?
Yeah.
You've got the papers and I've got the-